You are an energetic being first and foremost, so the quality of your energy field is really important. It works like a filter, each part of the field enabling or preventing whatever is turning up in your life. This is the Future Self Energetics Show. I'm your host, Amanda Nelson, and I work in the body, mind and spirits community. I'm an award-winning master energist. That's a therapist that specializes in improving the quality of the energy fields that move in, through and around your body. If you want anything in your life to change, you have to begin with changing your energy field first. So my shows are a mixture of talk and therapy ideas, interviews and thought-provoking inspiration. They're all about energy, energy fields, protection and connection. If there's a topic you'd love me to cover in my show, please email me, amanda@futureselfenergetics.com. And if you love the show here on UK Health Radio, please spread the word about it in your networks. This is the Future Self Energetics Show on UK Health Radio. I'm your host, Amanda Nelson, and on my show this week, we're continuing to find out a little bit more about lightworkers. A lightworker is any person that's here on the planet at this time in order to make their contribution to the advancement of our consciousness on the planet. We lightworkers are all about raising up the vibration of the energy frequencies that are around us, and we're each on our individual mission, our unique mission, to raise the planet up in our own special ways. If you're a lightworker, then you have a special spiritual mission. If you don't know what your mission is, then the next step, for me anyway, has to be to find out what it is. Now, many lightworkers feel that they have a deep calling within them, and it's a calling that they know they have to answer. So you, as a lightworker, will begin a voyage of self-discovery if this is you. And that's what this programme today on UK Health Radio is about. I'd like to share some more of what I know about lightworkers so that you can find out more about yourself, and hopefully it will help to reveal more of your unique mission. I believe there are 15 main types of lightworkers. That's what I've recognised anyway. And these types of lightworkers give us clues about the mission that each of the lightworker is on. I mean, who wouldn't want to discover more about themselves on such an important level? So get a paper and pen ready if you haven't already, because we're about to get going. So I believe I recognise 15 different types of lightworkers, distinctive characteristics that give you an idea of the lightworker mission that you're on. And all lightworkers have at least one of these traits. I often find that lightworkers actually can identify with more than one, and I certainly do. So let me tell you a little bit about some of the traits that I have. Well, for sure, I think most of all, I'm a guardian lightworker. For me, your safety as a lightworker is a huge part of my mission, and I'll go out of my way in order to keep you safe. I'm also a grid worker. That means I'm working in the energy fields that form the basis of all things. I'm also a manifester. That means I weave the light to support creation of new useful things. And as a divine blueprint holder, I can see and connect with all types of divine and sacred codes. I think another of my strengths is that I'm also a transmuter of energy. This is what I do every day in my therapy. Transmuters like me bring their light to a situation that needs it, and as we are the energy converters, we can effortlessly flip negative energy to positive energy. We can take unbalanced energy and restore it back to balance again. I use these amazing skills, these lightworker skills, in my Future Self Energetics therapy sessions with my clients, and it benefits them. Many of my clients are actually lightworkers, and we soon find this out, and then we work so that we can get them on their purpose and successful on their mission. So I understand this is who I am, and it makes it much simpler for me to see why I am who I am on a spiritual level, and why I'm not like some other light workers that I've met, and that's okay too. We've all got our own important, unique mission, and each one of us has our own unique part to play. There shouldn't be two of us that are the same. So listen to the descriptions of the 15 lightworker types that I'm about to share with you. And every time you feel you relate with one of these descriptions on some level, write down the type it is. And by the end of the show today, you're going to have a precious picture of who you are and what makes you so special in your own way as a lightworker. So for each type of lightworker, I'm going to give you the name first and then a description of it. And at the end of the description, all you need to do is to, after the name of the lightworker, put a tick or a cross next to it. And if the description that I've given is you to an absolute T, if you know to the core of the fabric of your being that it's you, then put a big star next to it so that you know which type of lightworker you are most of all.
Apples and pears, beef and skittles, cider with Rosie, common or garden, ant and deck, fish and chips, mum and dad.
UK Health Radio and Health Triangle magazine. Each is good by itself, but enjoying both is always better. Add Health Triangle magazine to your monthly health regime. Check it out at ukhealthradio.com. Strawberries and cream.
Once upon a time, human slavery was just a fact of life. Right now, animal abuse is often considered normal. In time, it won't be. Animal Aid campaigns peacefully against all forms of animal abuse and promotes cruelty-free living.
Check out animalaid.org.uk. It's time for a kinder world.
The station that makes you feel good.
UK Health Radio.
The station that makes you feel good.
First of all, then, the Ascension Guides. The Ascension Guides challenge old paradigms and they point the way to new ones. Ascension guides challenge old ways of doing things and they offer new solutions. Now they might contradict old teachings, even old well-established spiritual teachings, so support them, because even if they challenge you because their role is to speak the truth for a new age, they speak from the higher point of view, and that's the place that the rest of us are actually trying to reach. So the Ascension Guides. Are you an Ascension Guide? Next, then, the Blueprint Holders. Sometimes these are known as Divine Blueprint Holders. Now, every lightworker has a code that's stored within them. And this blueprint code is part of the key to their life purpose here on the planet at this time. And although we all have these codes, they only unlock at certain choice points or when certain events happen. Some lightworkers retrieve divine light codes from inside themselves, and some lightworkers retrieve divine codes from outside their being. These divine codes will help everyone in general. After they tune into these codes, they then translate them, sharing what they've uncovered for the benefit of everyone else. Now, the Divine Blueprint Holders, they use sacred geometry, they understand other forms of sacred communication as well, and they can be found in any walk of life, but it's how they work creatively and how they do things that matter. They are able to consciously or subconsciously discover, reveal and communicate for the benefit of all of us. Next, the Dreamers. Now, dreamers travel the dream space. They move with their visioning through different dimensions. And they're psychonauts. They launch themselves outwards and then they can inspire and uplift others. Dreamers that share their message are the inventors. They're the creative technologists and artists. They're the authors, the theoretical scientists and so forth. The dreamers are the imagineers and free thinkers of our time. Now, sometimes dreamers can get very caught up in the dreaming that they prefer to be connecting with. So they like to be in the dream state rather than in reality. Sometimes they can even forget to share what they've learnt in their dreams. I know many dreamers that would really rather not spend much time in reality at all. They can spend a great deal of time visioning or spending time in meditations, trying to journey. They might be doing a lot of astral travelling. That's okay for dreamers. That's their natural state of being, as long as they remember to come home to Earth and share what they have found with the rest of us, then it will benefit us brilliantly. Are you a dreamer? Don't forget to write down if you think you might be. Next, we come to the healers. Now, the healers, a huge group. They work mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually, extraterrestrially, interdimensionally. All aspects are available to be healed, and therefore all aspects need healing. As a healer, you could use your gifts through service generally, is what I found. You could be a counsellor, a medic, a therapist, a friendly ear, a volunteer, a wish granter, and more. If you're any of these things, you're a healer. You support, you serve, you love, and you guide others. Next comes the grid worker and the gatekeeper. Could you be either of these? Now, there are energy grids that flow in, around and through all beings, and these energy grids need managing to ensure we can all stay well connected. The energy grids all interconnect and they overlay, and they nest and they overlap like a busy circuit board of never-ending energy streams in an unlimited matrix. The grid workers, as the name would suggest, they create, they manage and they maintain the grids that link us all together. And these energy grids can be already measured, they can be observed in the cosmos around the planet. They're here on the planet, known as ley lines and sacred sight lines. And these grid lines link all souls as well, from one heart to another. These grids are unlimited and they stretch way beyond our imagination, and they are divine energy lattices that connect everyone to everything else that can be. Now, the gatekeepers are advanced grid workers. They have an additional role in that they open and close doorways and energy passageways. So I'm a grid worker and I'm also a gatekeeper. And what we do is we keep an eye on the grids. We know where the portals are. And the purpose of each portal as well, and what should or shouldn't be passing through them. And this brings me to the next of the light worker types. This is a guardian light worker, where these psychic bodyguards, if you like. The guardians are here to protect the energy grids and to protect the light workers, those who are bearing the light. Guardians energetically run towards what others run away from, and they stand their ground and they stare things down energetically. They're the shields and the bodyguards. Now, when guardians do their job properly, no one's going to notice. Guardians do a lot of their work on the planetary grids in secret, and we carry on behind the scenes. We tend to keep a low profile about being a guardian as well. In fact, you'll find guardians wait until the time is right before they speak up and they reveal who they are and what they're here to do. Now, in essence, guardians are here to make sure that light workers can build up their power and that they feel well protected as they light up, as they share their wisdom, as they evolve and as they grow. So the guardians keep the light workers safe and they teach them how to shield themselves and to protect themselves effectively as well. Are you a guardian? One of the other things I've noticed about guardians is guardians tend to have an affinity with quite a lot of the 15 of the different traits. It's as if they need to understand the majority of the different light worker traits and the different skills that would be involved in using those traits. It's quite fascinating. Next, we come to the light keepers or the divine light keepers. I wonder, are you going to be one of these? Now, the light keepers or divine light keepers are the souls who embody the higher light frequencies on the earth. And whatever happens, whatever they face or is being faced in the world around them, their core mission is always to continue to embody the divine light. They're here to retain a much higher vibrational frequency, being constant and highly present. Light keepers, they say, are the lighthouse of humanity. If you can make other people laugh, you're probably a light keeper. If you motivate others to be more than they feel they currently are, for example, as a speaker or a teacher or as a role model or a parent or a friend, then you're probably a light keeper as well. And the key to this type is that they inspire people to rise. They show us how to shine our light more brightly because we've spent time with them. Some of the light keepers I know will merely sit and, despite everything that is going on around them, they're the ones who remain constant, positive and lit up. So if you're somebody who has a calm head in the time of crisis and you can always see the way forward that is positive for people, then it's quite likely you're a light keeper as well. Just being near a divine light keeper means that people receive hope and inspiration when they otherwise may feel about to give up. How relevant nowadays. They uplift humanity and they help others to recognize that they too are unfolding and that they're growing. Next, the manifestors. Now, the manifestors are light weavers. They weave light to create a positive state of being for the rest of us to benefit from. And they work from the heart, so the templates they create are loving and they're harmonious in nature. And the manifestors have a really clear intention to manifest for the highest benefit of all beings. So that would be our planet, it would be the animals and more. And they generate a flow of love and a desire for codependency for all humanity to benefit one from the other. Now, manifestors may use meditation, visualization, affirmations, any of those and more in order to weave their light. And they sit in the knowledge that the energy that they're generating on behalf of the rest of us is going to really make a difference. And if they resonate with positivity, it makes it much easier for the rest of us to resonate positively as well. And their positive energy will flow effortlessly to the places, the people, the spaces and events that need it the most. Now, as there needs to be a balance in all things, the manifestors also appreciate that sometimes it's about weaving a template for self-love. It's about weaving a template that allows for self-benefit, weaving a template for harmony for themselves as well. Manifestors never work from the ego, and manifestors are never in competition. They always work in cooperation. Next, we move on to the messengers. Throughout history, there are those amongst us who are able to share really powerful insights that have been passed to them. And these messages are downloaded from the higher realms, and the insights that they contain are going to give us timely guidance just at the point when the rest of us need us. It's like they enable us to move forward on our journeys. Now, some messengers have an absolutely huge message. It's a message for the whole of humanity, and it's quite an art to be a good messenger. First, messengers need to be open to receive the messages that are being sent for the benefit of the rest of us. And secondly, they need to be good communicators to be able to explain what message they've received is for and how it will benefit us. Third, messengers need to be prepared to work absolutely in trust. And they have to put their egos aside in order to share what they receive exactly as they receive it. They mustn't overthink it. They mustn't change the message by filtering it or indeed by getting in the way of it. Now, not all messengers have a huge message. For some messengers, they whisper their messages. They connect with people on a one-to-one or a one-to-a-few level. And simply by saying the right words at the right time, in the right way, the messengers deliver their message. Next, we come to the seers. Now, these light workers have opened up their third eye and they see beyond the limitations of the physical world around us. Seers have highly attuned extended senses. They have psychic skills and they may be empaths or telepaths as well. So empaths, they feel it as if it's theirs. Telepaths, they know it as if it is theirs. So the seers, their role is to inspire you, to empower you and to guide others to their truth and the truth of the world. The seers help reveal the truth behind the shadows and they show us how we can shift our perspectives and our understandings so that we can develop and change. Now, most seers are really good psychiatrists. Think parapsychologists like Carl Jung, truth activists, or even professional psychics. Could you be a seer? If you are, make sure that you write that down. Then there are the transmuters. Now, energy can't be destroyed. It can only be converted into a different type of energy. And transmuters, they bring their light to a situation that needs it. And as they are the energy converters, they can effortlessly flip negative energy to positive energy or take unbalanced energy and restore it back to balance again. In conversations, situations, and all manner of circumstances, the transmuters will hold the space and then bring the energy back into balance again, keeping things stable so that we can bring ourselves back into our right centeredness. Balance is not restricted to a single state of being, and the transmuters are really aware of this. Imbalance can sometimes come from different dimensions or realities. Imbalance can disrupt timelines as well. So transmuters understand that balance affects multiple timelines simultaneously. So the transmuters often work across time boundaries and get involved in past and future life work as well. Next, the unifiers. The unifiers bring things together and form them in a unified whole in a way that we hadn't quite seen it before. Unifiers see past prejudices and agendas, and these light workers are able to see how if you take a little bit of this and a little bit of that, inspiration from here, a thought form from there, a teaching from this person, a truth from that spiritual master, and by adding them all together, you get something much greater than a sum of the parts. Unifiers reveal the root essence that will be of the most value to lightworkers, enabling lightworkers to apply this unified learning in a way that's really easy for them to understand. Unifiers help lightworkers see their common goals and values so that they can come together as a united front. The Wayshowers. Wayshowers live an awakened and positively inspired life. They are the role models for the rest of us. And the irony is they sometimes don't even realise how much they are serving humanity simply by being authentically true to themselves. Wayshowers live in resonance with their inner knowing and they respect the teachings they receive from other lightworkers. Wayshowers have huge heart centres and they inspire and motivate others by leading through example. They live a life that illustrates all that really matters. Finally then, the antagonists. Now then, antagonists are light workers that oppose or can sometimes even seem hostile to someone or something. This is arguably, I think, an isolated and difficult pathway for any light worker to take. And I really admire the antagonists because it's not going to be easy for them sometimes. Antagonists come along and they shake things up. And they speak up when others are silent. And they'll be an activist that comes across as an adversary. And they're pushy. And they're the person that shines a light on something that needs to be changed and that no one else seems to be highlighting. And they won't shut up about it. They won't back off. And their actions may generate a deep-seated response in any one of us that will move us to behave in a way that is not comfortable for us at all. Antagonists are the ones that manage to move us in a direction that we're reluctant to go in. And they help us to change our attention, our focus and our pathway when nothing else will. So you can see antagonists as light workers. They're kind of Marmite. You love them and you can hate them and you can do it all at the same time. So those are the 15 types of light workers, the ascension guides, the blueprint holders, the dreamers, the healers, the grid workers and gatekeepers, the guardians, the light keepers, the manifestors, the messengers, the seers, the transmuters, the unifiers, the way showers, and the antagonists. Are you a light worker? Which type of light worker are you? And will it give you some idea of the mission that you are on? I hope so.
Call my name, ooh, so sweet, to make your kiss incomplete. When your mood is clear, you quickly change your ways. Then you say I'm untrue. What am I supposed to do? Be a fool who sits alone waiting for you. I see the light of your smile, calling me all the while. You are saying, baby, it's time to go. First the feeling's all right, then it's gone from sight. So I've taken out this time to say,
that makes you feel good. UK Health Radio. Radio, the station that makes you feel good.
That's it for another show this week. I'm thrilled that you dropped by. I present Future Self Energetic Show every week for UK Health Radio, and I'd be delighted to spend more time with you next week, so do tune in. The world of energy is amazing, and it's magical, and it's mysterious, and there's always so much for us to explore about it. You have a vital connection to a web of energy fields around you. Use that connection for your benefit. I've been working with vibrational energetics all my life, and I know that when you improve your energy field, you can up-level any part of your life. You can find out more about me, my courses, and Future Self Energetics at my lifestyle website, beyondthegoldenegg.com. I'm also on Twitter. You can find me at Ask Amanda Nelson. Focus on the quality of the energy in your energy field. Focus on your entire energy field every single day, because a great energy field has the potential to change anything. I'm looking forward to connecting with you again next week. Love to you and yours. Bye-bye.